Good morning, students. How are you? I hope all you are fine and studying well. I am Samir, and today I am going to teach you Standard 7, English 2, Grammar, Chapter Number 2, Nouns. In previous class, you have already learnt the types of nouns. So there are 5 types of nouns. The first one is proper noun, second common noun, then material noun, then collective noun, then abstract noun. So now let's understand through this picture, through this detail. Let's make a mango smoothie. So what you will need? You will need a cup plain curd. Here you have to observe green indicated word. Cup plain curd. Cup and curd. 1.5 cup milk. Here is milk. 1 cup chopped ripe mango. Sugar to taste. Now method. Put the mango curd, milk and sugar into blender. Blend for 2 minutes. Pour into glasses. Keep in the refrigerator, serve chilled. So these words in color are nouns: refrigerator, glasses, minutes, blender, mango, sugar, milk, curd. So these words in a color are nouns. Which of them can you count in numbers? Say yes or no. For example, for a sugar, you cannot say, please give me a 1 sugar. However, you can say that, please give me a spoon of sugar. Now, in chapter of noun, I will teach you countable and uncountable nouns. We know that the names of things, people, places and animals are called nouns. So in nouns, noun can be classified into 2 categories, countable and uncountable nouns. What is countable first? The names of people and things that can be counted are countable nouns. They can be used in singular and the plural form. Let me show you one picture. Here you can see the countable nouns and uncountable nouns. Eggs, countable. Banana, countable. With the milk and flow, uncountable. Olive, fries, burger, hot dog, apple, carrots, tomatoes, watermelon, salt, sugar, jam, meat, rice, honey, tea, cheese, and uncountable noun. These are the examples of uncountables. Here, more example is given here. You can see and observe the picture. Countable nouns and uncountable nouns. A noun that can be count, an uncountable noun that cannot be count. That is countables and uncountable nouns. So the names of the people, things that can be counted are countable nouns. They can be used in singular and the plural. For example, an iPad, iPads, a game, games, a phone, phones, etc. The names of things that can be used only the singular form are uncountable noun. For example, sugar, information, cash, rice, knowledge, etc. You observe in picture. However, we can say 2 spoon of sugar, these 3 bits of information and 3 bags of rice. Abstract nouns and material nouns are usually uncountable nouns. For example, joy, courage, fear, bravery are abstract nouns. wood, silver, clay, iron, material nouns. These are uncountable nouns, examples of uncountable. The article a and can be used with countable nouns in the singular form. We can also use one with singular countable nouns. A battery, an inverter, one laptop also. Uncountable nouns can only be used in singular form. The articles a or an cannot be used with them. A justice and honesty. Countable nouns can be qualified by words, phrases like a few, many, several, two, or three in plural form. For example, a few buildings, many trees, 2 kilometers. Uncountable nouns can be qualified by determiners such as some, much, a little, and less. Some coffee, a little money, less weight, etc. The names of some things which have two parts forming a kind of pair end with an S. These nouns are considered singular. We use the phrase a pair of. What is a pair of before such nouns? Such phrases are called quantifiers. Jeans, a pair of jeans, a pair of spectacles, a pair of pants, a pair of scissors, a pair of binoculars, a pair of trousers. For example, my uncle bought me a new pair of jeans on my birthday. I bought a pair of binoculars before going bird watching with my aunt. One more note down here. Some abstract nouns like color and liberty are countable in some contexts. The new series of books is full of color. Here color indicated uncountable. I like vibrant color. The vibrant color is countable. Children like to be at liberty to do as they please. Uncountable liberties. Please do not take liberties with the law is countable. In fact, very few nouns are only uncountable. Whether a noun is uncountable or countable or uncountable depends on context which is it is used. Now singular and plural. So observe this picture. Here one apple, others either side two apples. So singular is one thing and plural is more than one thing. Yani ek se zyada ho wo plural hai aur ek hi ho wo singular hai, that is singular. So countable nouns have a singular and plural forms. For example, cow, cows, whose, geese, etc. Uncountable nouns do not have a plural form. Uncountable noun do not have plural form. Courage, happiness, cottons. We cannot say courages, happinesses, and cottons. So some nouns are always used in singular form. They do not change in plural form. For example, the rule is abstract noun, common noun, and material noun cannot change in the plural form. Abstract noun means fun, freedom, music, permission, employment, and education. Common noun, petrol, butter, jewelry, machinery, milk, police. Material noun, glass, silver, gold, iron. So you need the principal's permission if you want to go home early. You will have to take my parents' permission to stay back school for football practice. My car runs on petrol. All the models of car launched by this company run on petrol. So Some uncountable nouns do not change in the plural form. However, the quantifier such as a piece of, but a piece of is added before this word to use them in plural. Right? Furniture, advice, information, chalk, luggage. So you have to put it every a piece of furniture in this shop is beautiful. There are too many pieces of furniture in this room. So the quantities of the things like oil, cloth and gold can be denoted by their measurement or an estimate of it. So 3 liters of oil, 5 meters of cloth, a pinch of salt. Now collective noun. What is collective noun? Let us understand through this picture. A collection of things. Collective noun is the name of the collection of people or things that are taken together and spoken of as one whole. For example, a school of fish, a parliament of owls, a murder of crows, etc. Here you can see the collective nouns for the people. A group of people. A side of Morris dancer, a scale of pay pipers, a slate of candidates, a slouch of models, a shot of shepherds. Here you can see the examples. These are the examples of collective noun. A team of athletes, a team of players, a top of males, etc. Now let us recall 5 types of nouns. First, proper noun. A proper noun is the name of the particular person, place or things. A common noun is the name of given a common to every person, place, animal or thing of same class or kind. A collective noun is the name of collection of person, animal or things spoken as one whole. A material noun is the name of material out of which things are made. An abstract noun is the name of something that you cannot touch, taste, hear, smell or see. It referred to a things which does not exist as a material object. And nouns can be classified into countable and uncountable. A countable noun can be counted. It can be used in the singular or plural. An uncountable noun cannot usually be counted without using determined quantifier. It can be used as a singular form. Now, I hope you understand this topic. Thank you.